Today is still the 12th of April. I knew the first 24 hours would be the hardest. I'm doing pretty good. Sticking to the plan. But basically, I'm trying to convince my brain that I can make things better for him. My brain is trying to convince me that I can make things better for him. My brain is trying to convince me that I will feel better about all of this if I just go in there and give him love and give him attention and make him feel better. I know he is miserable right now. I know he is hurting. I know he's in a lot of pain. And I hate that I have even a small portion to do with that. He thinks it's everything. He thinks it's all my fault that he's in pain. And maybe he's ready to take accountability for a small portion, but he tried texting me earlier, and in his texting he told me that he had some rum, and he also had an edible gummy, and two edible gummies, so I know he's smashed. Like, he is, like, totally out of it in there. And when he's intoxicated, he's a lot easier to deal with, so of course my brain is like, hey, if you're gonna try to talk to him and talk some sense into him, now's probably as good a time as any, and you'll feel better. And, no, what are you doing, brain? Don't try to talk me into that. So I've been, like, engrossing myself into projects. I even created a slideshow with audio about how to help relationships and music, and I put a lot of time into it, really trying to process my feelings and direct the angle I want to present this to him in. Like, dude, don't you understand that you just need to change this and I'll be happy? That's what my brain's trying to convince me. My brain is trying to convince me that if I can convince him that he just needs to change this one thing, then I'll be good. But that's not true. It's not true that Jim needs to change one thing and I'll be good. I'm not good, even if Jim was perfect. I don't have a lot of value in myself. I don't have a lot of self-worth. And the only reason why I know it's really low is because of how it shows up in my marriage with Jim. Because he doesn't have a lot of self-worth. So because I'm constantly trying to give him self-worth by fixing his insecurities, by fixing his jealousy, it was wearing on the little self-worth that I did have, the little bit of value I did have. And then he was constantly questioning me because I didn't have a lot of self-worth that he couldn't fix for me. And I was constantly looking to him to fix it for me. And so here we are trying to fix it for each other, and we weren't doing a very good job because we didn't have very much to give to ourselves. So we are totally two codependent people that cannot get a grip on life when we don't have each other to feed our supply. To supply us with what we need. Am I making any sense? The only reason why I am in here and he is in there is because I recognize my addiction and I want to stop it. I refuse to be addicted any longer. And just like with any addiction, I can't just cut cold turkey and not have any more temptations. I've got to practice not giving into the temptation before I can feel safe around the temptation. I do not feel safe around him. And not because he's dangerous, but because I'm dangerous. I know what I do when I'm around him. I know what I do when I'm near him. I know what I do when I see him in pain. I know what I do when he's feeling insecure and jealous. I try to fix it for him. I put my self-worth and my values aside, and I change my mind to suit what he needs. I tell him what he wants to hear. I don't speak my truth. I'm not valued in my own eyes because I put him on this pedestal. So no, I'm not okay with all that. And because I'm aware of it now, because I know it now, because I understand it now, I can separate myself and force myself to be here. Just like an alcoholic who's tired of being an alcoholic can dump all their alcohol down the sink. But he's addicted to me too. He's addicted to getting his self-worth from me. And what happens if you take an alcoholic's alcohol and you dump that alcohol for them? They are in agony. They are in pain. They don't understand. They're not ready for this. This isn't their choice. This isn't what they wanted. They don't see that they have a problem. They don't see that they're an alcoholic. They don't see that they've got an addiction issue. They don't see that they're broken. They just see you as the person that's taken away their alcohol, taken away their coping thing, taken away their self-soothing thing. I took away Jim's alcohol. I took away Jim's self-soothing thing. I took me away from him to save me. I did it to save me. And as much as I know that's hurting him, as much as I know that's killing him, I want to go in there and rush in there and save him and make him feel better and make him feel everything he wants to feel so that I can feel better about me, so I can get my fix again, my fix that I'm worthy. I'm worthy because Jim loves me again. But it took years Experimenting, I guess. Testing. All I kept doing was trying to fix it for him. All I kept doing was telling him what he wanted to hear, telling him what he wanted to hear, telling him what he wanted to hear. It took years of lying to him for me to finally realize, like, you know what? Even if I mean these words, even if I don't, just because I'm telling him what he wants to hear, he's not any better. He's not. I don't feel any better about me. I don't feel any more worthy now than I did. But I understand the addiction. I think it's like a quick fix. It's like a temporary band-aid. It's like a short high. It's a short buzz to get that moment of approval. So what am I doing now? I'm Marco Poloing everybody. I'm Marco Poloing like crap. I can't stop talking. I can't stop listening. I can't stop talking. I can't stop listening. Okay, Crystal, stop it. It's not bad to reach out to my support system, but I'm searching for my approval. I'm searching for my worth. I'm begging people to remind me of my worth. I'm begging people to remind me that I'm okay without him. I'm okay without him, right? I'm doing this personal video journal instead of a Marco Polo. Because I'm going to watch my Marco Polos here in a second. And instead of being real and honest about my temptations, I want to present myself as grateful and strong. It's not that I want to lie to people. I just don't want them to worry. And I recognize even in that, I'm worried about what they think, or I'm worried about how they feel, or I'm taking their feelings on like it's my own. I don't know, maybe tears will come out. I'm gonna go Marco Polo, people. If tears come out, tears come out. If I get real, I get real. If I don't get real, if I'm fake and phony, I don't know, I'm feeling so confused. But I've been confused for a really long time. This is nothing new. I'm striving so hard to be the best person I can be. And I'm getting better at being the person that I think I truly want to be. I'm learning lots, and I'm so freaking scared, and I'm also excited, and I'm also sad, and I'm grateful, and I'm mad. I'm all the kinds of emotions. My kids are so excited. They're not saying that. They're not telling me that. They're not using those words in their vocabulary. They are coming to me with smiles. And they're looking at me with smiles. And they're coming up to me with hugs. And they're hanging out with me just because. That kind of rhymed. I should make that into a poem. I just dropped my phone. My hand keeps falling asleep. I think I need a tripod just for my bed. Or, you know, one of those phone holders that you have in the car. Yeah, I need one of those for my bed. Anyway. I've spoken long enough here. I'm gonna probably post this. And if I feel inspired to give the link to somebody, I will. But it will be a private post. What I was saying about the kids is they are just, I think they can see something. I don't know if they can define it, but I can tell that they're enjoying having me back, and I'm not all about Jim, and I'm not all about myself, and all about Jim, and all about myself. The last 24 hours have been about them or me. But when they see me, I'm not anxious. I'm not sad. I'm not distracted. I'm not, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not self-involved. I've been more healthy in these last 24 hours than I have been in a long time. All right, I'm going to listen to my Marco Polos, and then I'm going to go to bed. Good night, everybody. Good night, Crystal. Remember, you are worthy. You are loved. And you are worthy of your self-love, primarily.